Hi, my name is Alexander Matthews, Technical Sales Solutions Specialist for Toon Boom Animation. And today I'll take you through Harmony 22. So I'm going to start off by showing you some drawing tools. So the first thing I'm going to do is drag my drawing tools template into my scene. And the great thing about Toon Boom Harmony 22 is that you can work natively in both bitmap and in vector. So to use your bitmap tools, you have to select your bitmap layer, and you'll have access to your bitmap brush. With your bitmap brush, you have a number of presets that you already have available to you. And by clicking on this button, you can bring up your bitmap brush properties. From here, you have the option to create your own unique brush. So we have our tip options here, where you can set the maximum and minimum size, roundness and angle, pen tilt sensitivity, hardness, etc. We have a transparency tab, a dual tip tab, where you can add more than one texture to your brush, and you can also even add a paper texture. From this button, you have your size properties. This is where you'll determine how the maximum and minimum size of your brush is generated, whether it be by the pressure, the tilt of your pen, or the speed at which you're drawing. In terms of the tilt, I'm talking about the angle of the pen while you're drawing. So when you're using your bitmap brush, you can also adjust the maximum size from this slider here. And when you draw, you'll notice that it is one solid drawing, it's flat. But you can easily get rid of any strokes that you don't want by selecting it with our cutter tool and hitting delete on your keyboard to get rid of it. It's that easy. So now let's have a look at the vector tools. With our vector brush, we have similar options over here to create your own unique brush. You have your vector brush properties where you can add your different customizations. And the great thing is that once you do this, you can actually save it and share it with others so that everyone has the same brush. This goes for both bitmap and for vector. So with your vector brush, if I zoom in here, you now have access to our select tool where you can select your stroke and move it around. You can squash it and stretch it as well as rotate it. And you can do this with one or several of your strokes at the same time. Also, you can use our contour editor. In the contour editor, you have the ability to modify your line by using the contour stroke on the outside of the line or using the Bezier handles connected to the contour nodes. You even have access to the centerline editor. When you use this tool, you'll have a centerline that runs through the center of your brush. And again, you can adjust it by moving the line like this or by selecting the control nodes and using your Bezier handles. In addition to that, with the centerline editor, you also have your centerline smoothness. So if I use a slider here, you can see that the number of nodes that are connected to the line increase or decrease depending on how smooth the line is. This would allow you to add more control to your lines. So next up, we have our texture vector brush. Now from here, it might look like it's a bitmap drawing, but if I zoom in and I use my contour editor, I can see that I still have control over modifying my line like that, as well as using the centerline editor to change the orientation of my stroke like this. So that's pretty much it for the textured brush. So let's look at the pencil tool now. The pencil tool is probably the more widely used of the vector drawing tools because of how customizable and how flexible it is. So I can use my select tool again to select my pencil line. Again, I can modify it this way. I can select multiple at the same time. And what's great about the pencil tool is that you can actually change it after you draw, which is very unlike the vector brush. I can do this by selecting just one at a time and coming into my tool properties, where I can adjust the maximum size using the slider. I can input a value as well. And here you see it's very small now. Or I can select everything at the same time once I've drawn it, change the size this way, and I can even change the tapering of my lines after the fact, like that. If I want to as well, I can add a texture to my line. Also, we also have the contour editor where we can adjust the lines using our contour nodes, using the Bezier handles, and you can add contour points along your line to increase your control over how your line is drawn. So you also have the option of changing your pencil line to a brush stroke. All you have to do is select your strokes like this, go to Drawing, Convert pencil lines to brush strokes. If I zoom in here, you can see it is now a brush stroke as the contour line is on the outside of the line. You can have a quick look at our textured pencil. And using the same technique, by selecting all of our lines with our select tool, and go to Drawing, Convert pencil lines to brush strokes. By zooming, you can see that the texture of that line is maintained, and now I can go ahead and adjust it like this, or by using the center line editor as well. Okay, so now we're going to have a look at the stroke tool. With the stroke tool, in this example, you can see that we have areas of our drawing that we want to block off when it comes to painting. So in this area, we might want to have the white, but we don't want to have the connecting lines all around our eye shape. So I'm going to jump in to our drawing tab so we have a better view of this. And as you can see, we're missing our guidelines here, and that's because they exist on our overlay layer of this drawing. So with each drawing that you have four different layers that you can work with: the overlay, the line art, the color art, and the underlay layers. And you can use these layers to color or add notes up above and below your drawings. So we're going to work on our line art, but we're going to select our show all, our preview all art layers. And we're going to go into our paint tools and select our stroke tool. I'm going to zoom in, make sure I'm on my line art, and I'm going to draw my stroke like this. You'll get a message saying that you drew a stroke, but it won't be visible unless you show the strokes. That's okay. You can use your keyboard shortcut, K, or you can go to View, Show Strokes. The great thing about the stroke tool is that you can actually use your contour editor to adjust the lines after you draw them. So if you select my contour editor, I can zoom into the stroke that I just drew here. I can delete this contour node and adjust the line to suit. I'll add my other line over here. Select my contour, get rid of some of the points that I don't want. And just like that, I have closed off an area of my drawing. I can go to my color art layer And I can click on this button to create my color zones for my character. If I zoom in here, you can see that there are some areas where the lines aren't connected. So I can use this tool here, which is known as our snapping tool. And I can turn this on and I can snap these to each other to make sure that my areas are closed off. That did not go. And now if I use my paint bucket, go to my color, find my palette, and let's just use this color here. And when I paint in, you can see that it only filled this area of my drawing. And that's a great way to easily create those zones for your color. We also have an area here where we want to close off as per the guide notes. And we can use our close gap tool. Go to my line art. And I can draw a line easily like this. And now I can use my paint tool again, find my mouth fill, and fill in my area like that. And it's that easy to close off areas of your drawing. Next up, we're going to have a look at our cutter tool. And this is very handy for cleaning up your drawings when you're making them. As you see, we have several overlapping lines here. And my cutter tool can be found under my select tool menu. And with your cutter tool, you can easily just slash across your lines to quickly get rid of them, like that. And we have a tool here called our multiple lines cutting gesture. With this selected, you can easily slash across several lines at the same time and clean up your drawing even faster. And you can notice that the end of your, or the corner of your drawing has a nice rounded edge. This is because with this selection, you can choose what type of end to your line you want, whether it be round, flat, or beveled. Okay, now that I've gone through the majority of the drawing tools, I'm going to do some cleanup on this character. And this way you can see how easy it is to actually draw your lines. So I'm going to select a different drawing layer. I'm going to turn on my light table so that it will wash my sketch. I'm going to select my pencil tool. Now I'm going to talk to you about our stabilizers, and these help you create nice smooth lines for your drawings. We have two types of stabilizers. We have an average stabilizer and a pulled string stabilizer. With the average stabilizer, what this does, it takes the average drawing direction of your pen and smooths out the line that way. So I have my average stabilizer turned on. I can even use my rotating table to get a better angle to draw with. And I can make my line. That didn't come out so good. So let's talk about our pulled string stabilizer. With the pulled string stabilizer, this adds a leash to your stroke, and you can pull your line along with that little leash that's attached to it. So if I start drawing, you can see that there's a little guideline on the end of my stroke, and it's being pulled along by this leash. And that way I can generate some nice lines for my character. We also have the line tools, which have auto curve modes. The line tool is found under your shape tools. And you have in your tool properties these different modes here. Your straight line, where you can generate a straight line. With this auto curve, I can draw my line. And then I have the option of pulling or pushing my line to generate the curve that I want. And when I click again, it will add the curve that I chose. We also have the S-curve line, Again, I can draw my line. I can choose my first curve and my second curve and create it that way. I can see that I don't really like how this curve looks, so I'm going to use my contour editor. I'm going to select my line, add a contour point, and adjust it like this. And just like that, I've created my line. Okay, so that's the majority of the drawing tools. I have one more to show you, which is the perspective guide. And if you're terrible at drawing perspective like I am, this is a great tool for you to use. So you can go into your guides tab here, and you have the option of several different types of perspective to choose from right off the bat. The great news is that you can choose from these guides that we have here for you, and then you can save it and share it with other people. So I have a three-point perspective guide already in my scene, and you can see that the lines are generated for you. You can easily move your vanishing points around, as well as your horizon line. You can undo those changes. And you have the option of locking your guides once you've created the perspective that you want. That way, you can be sure that you won't mess up your perspective while you're drawing if you go too close to one of the vanishing points. The perspective guides will become available to you once you have a drawing tool selected, such as the pencil or the brush. So with your guides and with this turned on, the align with guide, if I zoom in, you can see that my cursor has guides on it as well. So I can easily line up the different areas that I want to draw, and I can easily and quickly draw my lines like this. There may be a case where it does not exactly line up with your guide, but this is when you can easily go and unlock your guide, adjust your vanishing point to make it work for you. You can also uncheck your align with guide. So for example, with this area here, this is a nice sloped roof. So I can use my pencil tool. I can select my pull string stabilizer, and I can go ahead and quickly draw the nice sloped edges of my roof. I can make any adjustments that I need quickly like this. And I can turn my guide on again, or lock my guide again, and start drawing my straight lines one more time. And that's basically your perspective guides. That pretty much concludes all of the different drawing tools that you have available to you. There are a lot more that you can select from, which you can experiment with as you use the software. But thank you for joining me. And if you have any more questions, please visit www.toonboom.com. Thanks for joining me.